Hey Pixels! In this week's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to code an action grid using the Flexbox layout, an easy and quick way to create a responsive grid layout on any website with CSS3. This tutorial will feature three action boxes: download, upload, and share. They also feature icons from Font Awesome. Be sure to visit my website, exopixel.com, and read the article, interact with the live demo, and download the source files for this tutorial. Now, let's jump right in. First, we're going to create a section and give it a unique class name called ExopSection. Within the section, we're going to use the div tag, then we'll give it the class ExopWrapper. Then we're going to create another div class named ExopContainer. Now, we're going to code the actual action box. First, we're going to create a div and give it the class ActionBox. Within the ActionBox div, we're going to use the heading tag for the heading and the p tag for the lines of text below the heading. Lastly, we're going to use the button tag and give it a class called ExopBTN. Within the button tag, we're going to name the actual button, so in this case, download. And then we're going to add an icon right next to the text. The icon is from Font Awesome, and I'm just going to use the HTML method for adding the icon. Alright, so we've coded our first action box. To make our other two action boxes, all we need to do is highlight the code up to the XOP action box div and then paste it two more times below. Then we're just going to change the heading text and the text in the button. Finally, we're going to grab the icons that relate to each button type, so an upload icon and then a sharing icon. Well, that's it for the HTML. Now let's head on over to our CSS. The first thing that we're going to do in our CSS file is give our entire page a really nice purple background. Then, we're going to select ExopSection and style the properties relating to the fonts we'll be using in this section. Then, we're going to select ExopWrapper, which will give a max width of 85% and a width of 960 pixels, and finally set margin to 0 auto to center everything. Now, we're going to select ExopContainer and use the display flex declaration. That means we're going to be using the famous flex layout on the content within the container. Using the Flexbox layout makes it so much easier to make your content responsive. You're also going to be using a lot less code in your CSS file. Finally, we're going to add a 2% margin to the top and bottom of the container. Now, we're going to select the actual action box so that we can apply some really nice styles to it. First, let's set the width and height of the box to 270 pixels. Then, we're going to add a purple background color to the box. We're going to center align the text and color it white. We're going to add 40 pixels of padding and then add a 10 pixel border radius to give the box rounded corners. Finally, we're going to give the box a 2% padding all around so that they have some breathing room beside each other. Now, we're going to set the responsiveness of the action boxes. First, let's declare the media screen property for when the browser is 1070 pixels and smaller. That seems to be the breaking point for the boxes in my browser. I'm going to select ExopContainer and set its flex direction to column. That means that when the browser is 1070 pixels or smaller, it will automatically move the items into a column layout, which is ideal when scrolling a website on a mobile phone. I'm going to select ExopActionBox and set its height to 270 pixels and its width to 200 pixels. I don't want the action box to look too wide on mobile screens. Well, we're almost done now. All we need to do is style the heading, text, and button within the action boxes. First, we're going to set the font size and weight of the headings and add a 2% margin to the top and bottom of the heading. To style the lines of text, we're just going to add some padding to the top and bottom and give it a line height of 1.4. Now, we just need to style the buttons. First, we're going to select ExopButton and give it a white background. We're going to remove the border and add 5% padding and set its width to 100%. We're going to color the text purple and set the font family style. We're also going to add round corners to the button. Finally, we're just going to style the hover state of the button. First, we're going to change its background color to a light purple and color its text white, and then change the cursor type to pointer. Well, there you have it. You've just coded a Flexbox action grid using HTML5 and CSS3. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to ExoPixel for more great coding videos just like this one. I'll see you in next week's video.